year, goals for the upcoming year, and information the CAC members would like to share. For the past few years, our CAC has held summer planning meetings to complete a needs assessment and help provide direction to the work of the CAC. This past summer, we met on August 14th and established goals for our group as a whole and for each of our subcommittees. Our first subcommittee is called Parent and Community Education. In February, the CAC, in collaboration with the Mount Diablo Adult Ed Department, hosted a mini-conference called Parenting the Child with Special Needs. A total of 49 participants attended, and it was a huge success. Workshop topics included building relationships, transition, effective IEP teams, and assistive technology. All workshop presenters, many of whom are district employees, donated their time. Parent comments were extremely positive. We are currently discussing whether we will host a mini conference every year or every other year. To assist our special ed students transition to a new school, the committee has also been developing a picture library of photos for all of our schools within the Mount Diablo School District. Photos are available for downloading so parents can make a photo book of their student moving to a different school site. This project is still a work in progress and photos will be posted as available. Our second subcommittee is called Membership and Publicity. Special ed can be very confusing. The CAC's main goal is to keep parents informed and to increase their knowledge about special ed policies and practices within Mount Diablo. Attending a CAC meeting can be confusing. Therefore, our subcommittee made it a priority to identify and welcome new parents attending CAC meetings, obtain their contact info, and follow up with each person to invite them to the next meeting. They created a welcome folder for parents attending the meeting for the first time. And they attended IEP trainings and hosted an information table at the mini conference to do outreach for CAC. Increasing our membership will continue to be a high priority. Our third subcommittee is our legislative committee. The Ledge Committee works to improve education for all students in the Mount Diablo School District by advocating for better education, legislation, and funding of mandated programs by our state government. Members of the committee attended Senator DeSaulnier's open house to meet with the senator and his staff. They wrote letters to the legislators and the governor regarding the governor's budget. They participated in the San Ramon PTA Advocacy Day to learn more about the governor's proposed budget and how the change to Common Core will affect our students with special needs. They attended the SELPA Ledge Day in Sacramento to speak with the legislators regarding current legislation and were thrilled to have our board member, Barbara Oakes, join them for this event. The committee tracks bills throughout the year regarding special education and disseminates the information so others are informed and encouraged to write letters. The committee's goal for next year is to involve the Mount Diablo community in letter writing and advocacy for special education issues. The CAC blog continues to be an online forum in supporting the committee's outreach, education, and membership goals. In addition to posting educational articles on issues related to special education and current legislative bills, we provide information on upcoming district events and link to community resources and activities. The blog will continue its mission to promote disability awareness, educate parents on special education, and to inform its readers about upcoming district and community events. Again this year, the CAC was represented at all of the Board of Education meetings and Budget Advisory Committee meetings. We have also added a representative to attend the monthly DLAC meetings. Two CAC parents continue to participate on the Equity Advisory Team to address issues of disproportionality in identifying students for special education, as well as issues of disproportionality around student suspensions and expulsions. This allows us to meet two of the CAC statutory roles, which is to advise the Board of Education and to reach out to the community and educate parents about special education. At our annual Celebration of Success event that was held on October 18th, the Mount Diablo School District recognized 45 special education students who had shown remarkable success during the previous school year. Every other year, the CAC sponsors the You Make a Difference Award celebration to honor individuals or organizations that have made an outstanding contribution to the lives of special education students in the Mount Diablo School District. This was the year that we did not host the event, so we look forward to this event next year. Our Quiet Committee has been renamed and is now called the Attack Committee. Quiet stood for Quality Indicators in Assistive Technology. Its goal was to collect data on the district's development and delivery of quality assistive technology services. As the district has moved forward from data collection to action, the focus of the committee has changed. The committee now focuses on the implementation of services and on the training of staff. This year, TAC has discussed improving the child find process for students with communication needs. The team suggested multiple methods for identifying students' needs and ensuring that they are provided with both high and low tech solutions in a timely fashion. Next year, we will continue to build the team and work on program needs and a permanent process for evaluating placements, site development, etc., to ensure students with communication needs are provided the necessary services and programs. Mount Diablo's Equity Advisory Team, which is comprised of staff, parents, and community members, was formed back in March 2011. The team meets on a monthly basis to address issues of disproportionality in identifying students for special education, as well as issues of disproportionality around student suspensions and expulsions. In Mount Diablo, African American and Hispanic male students are overrepresented in these areas. In July 2012, Mount Diablo was identified as significantly disproportionate for the over-identification of African American students for emotional disturbance. Therefore, Mount Diablo was required to create a coordinated early intervening services plan, outlining how the district will address disproportionality. Mount Diablo was also required to reallocate 15% of their existing federal special education funds for the 12-13 school year to support this effort, which totaled approximately $1.3 million. In September 2012, the Equity Leadership Committee, comprised of administrators, was formed. This team was created to develop the CSIS plan. So collaborating with the Equity Advisory Team, the Equity Leadership Committee developed the CSIS plan, which focuses on three areas that are aligned to existing efforts. These areas include response to intervention, positive behavior intervention, and supports in culturally responsive school environments. The plan has been approved by the CDE, and the district is moving forward with implementation. The Equity Leadership Committee will continue to meet over the summer with the new Equity Administrator. The Equity Advisory Team will start meeting again in the fall. In April 2012, the district hired FICMAT to perform two studies, one on transportation and one on special ed program finances. In regards to the transporting of students with special needs, we all agree that transportation is a related service per the student's IEP. The CAC supported the district's decision to revise their parent reimbursement policy and to implement a new transportation worksheet that was developed for staff to use in determining the need for transportation. As parents, we hope these new practices have assisted in not only providing transportation to the appropriate students, but also in decreasing our district's transportation costs. In regards to the FICMAT Special Education Program report, at the end of this report I've given you is a copy of the minutes taken by the CAC secretary from the parents group that met with Joanne Murphy, FICMAT consultant, on June 5th, 2012. At the end of this report, we have also included a copy of the CAC report to the Mount Diablo Board of Education that we made on March 11, 2013, stating our comments and concerns. In general, the CAC is very concerned about the impact prior reductions have had and continue to have on all Mount Diablo students, especially the special education population we represent. Federal and state laws require school districts to serve students in the least restrictive environment. To accomplish this in the most cost-effective manner, the district must work on building capacity so we can provide services in district programs by district employees. However, we must have equivalent, sustainable programs. We must have quality teachers with adequate supports. Schools must provide the education and accessibility these students require. District and school climate must support inclusion, and all staff must be trained accordingly. Dr. Mills has told us that she wants to involve parents as the district moves forward in discussing FICMAT recommendations.